Getting accurate feedback from customers about the products and services you sell is absolutely vital for growing a successful business. Surveys will give you the information you need to create more of what your audience loves and ditch the bits that they don't love quite so much. Having said that, some of the most popular survey brands aren't cheap. They cost between $350 to $530 per year for an individual plan. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create your own unique branded surveys like this using Google Forms. Once you've created a basic survey, I'm then going to show you how to transform it by customizing it with your own unique branding and maximizing your chance of getting a response from customers using one simple trick. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Nicky Pasquier. I'm a CANVA certified creative, and I help small businesses successfully market their brands online using some of the best marketing tips, tricks, and tools. So if you don't want to miss out, be sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on that bell notification so you're one of the first to know when I publish a new video. We've got a lot to cover today, so let's get started. Obviously, you'll need a Google account to do this, so log into your Google account and select Google Drive. I'm on my Google Drive already. On the far left-hand side, you'll see a little button that says New. Click on that. Scroll right down to the bottom until you see the purple icon and Google Forms next to it. Now click on this little tiny arrow by the side and you'll see that you can choose from either a blank form or a form template. I want to start with a blank form since I want to create a completely customised form. So I'm going to click on blank form and this is what a blank survey looks like. I'm going to start off right at the top by giving my form a name. Now I'm going to click on this little tiny paint palette icon because I want to start customising the theme. And now I'm going to add a large header image to the top of my survey. So I'm going to click on choose an image. You can choose from a selection of themes which are already formatted. You can upload your own image or you can choose from one of your Google photos. What I want to do is upload my own image. So to do that, I'm going to hop over to CANVA. I've already done some investigating and I know the size of template I need for this header image. I'll share the exact dimensions with you a little later on, so make sure you stay tuned. Since I want to survey my customers about a recent course I produced, I've designed a really quick header image with a relevant title, my brand logos, and some fun graphics. I'm now going to download this image by clicking on the download button, selecting my file type. I want a PNG high quality image. I'm going to select the page I want, which is the first page. Click done and then download. And I'm going to upload that header image by clicking on choose an image and then upload. If you need to crop your image at all, just hold your cursor over one of the corner buttons and drag it into place. I'm quite happy with the image as it is, so I'm just going to click on Done. And there is my header image right at the top of my survey. It's not only branded, but it also conveys to customers exactly what this survey is as soon as they open it. On the right-hand side, you'll probably notice that my theme options have pulled through the main colours from my header image. And this will help me maintain a consistent visual style if I want to add colour to my form. I can change the background colour of my survey by clicking on one of these buttons right here. And I can also select a font style. Okay, I'm done with theme options now, so I'm going to close this down. On the right-hand side of your form, you'll see a little toolbar. This will help you format your survey, add questions, add a title and description, add images, a video, and section breaks. So the next thing for me to do is start adding questions to my survey. So I'm going to click on Add Question. And the first question I want to ask my customers On a scale of 1 to 10, how much did you enjoy this course? And for this, I need to select from the drop-down menu a linear scale. I need to change the values and add value labels. You'll see some handy little tools at the foot of the question box. This one here enables you to duplicate this question. You can delete it, or you can make it a required question. Now I want my customers to answer this question, so I'm going to toggle this to the on position. Fabulous, that's the first of my questions done. So continue adding questions to your survey using the various question and answer formats. If your survey is a little lengthy, you can break it up using section breaks. And I'm going to add a question to section 2. And I'm going to use a paragraph answer format for this. And you can see already that our survey is really starting to take shape. If you want to preview your survey, just click on this little eye icon at the top. And this is exactly how your customers will see your survey. So far, so good. So that's all there is to creating a basic Google form. Now, I mentioned at the start of this tutorial that I was going to show you how to then add your custom branding and maximize your chances of getting customers actually filling in that form and returning them to you. So all you need to do is come back on Thursday when I'll be sharing those tips with you in the second part of this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching so far, and I really look forward to seeing you on Thursday.